Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with short information about the custom markup plugin table of contents. Yeah? So what can we see here? There is some basics information, and the basics and a little bit of advanced is already covered with the introduction plugins. Yeah, but there it is a little bit in more detail. Yeah, so for example, at the very beginning, how users can style paragraphs in Wikitext, yeah, which has nothing to do with the custom markup, but with the general TillyWiki Wikitext behavior. Yeah. Then there is some information about the users at the moment use paragraph indentation, and in the videos I have already shown how this can be done in a nice way. Yeah. Then there is some easy styling about paragraphs, first line indentation, and so on. Then there is some information about how CSS works, and some information about the predefined styles that come with the custom markup plugin. Then there is some information about colored boxes. So let's say you have the blue box, green box, and so on. So there are different boxes, which can be easily used, and in normal cases just assigned some classes. Then there is a little bit information about different columns, which can be used, which can be handy sometimes. This is more or less standard TillyWiki behavior. Then a little bit basics about advanced users, and then there is the different element that starts with custom markup, how to abstract away different HTML elements. Then there is some importing predefined pragmas. Then there is definition for global pragmas. Then there are some experiments with lists, with tables, which is not finished yet. So there is a lot to do with tables and custom tables with multi-line context, for example. I think it can be nice to be used with custom markup, but there is a lot of work which has to go into these tables. Tables are not finished yet. Then there is the reference, and the next video series I want to do is talking about the different elements and how they are used. So there is the definition of a custom markup, and then every element will need to be explained, and the next videos will talk about these different possibilities here. Then there is pragma import custom command. Then there is the information, some information about the different toolbar buttons which are new. Then the toolbar buttons configurations which are there. Then there are informations about the different shortcuts which are predefined, the predefined style sheets which are used here in the wiki, and the predefined style sheets which are part of the plugin. Then there is pragma comment, which is now possible with TillyWiki 5.2. This is very handy. Then there are some debugging possibilities. There is, I think there is a very powerful debugging tools which helped me a lot for debugging, but all of them have to be explained in detail so that they can really be used by users. And then there is some experiments going on. How can we bundle this information? Because the different pragmas, if you want to share this information, then you also, in normal cases, you also have to share the configuration about the dropdowns. So the different snippets, because there are a lot of snippets in normal cases. So when you define something, then in normal cases you should also ship your snippets with the whole configuration. And with the Bundler plugin, it's possible to do this. For example, the presentation that I showed in the other videos has a configuration tiller like this, and it contains everything which is needed to get the presentation going. And there are some experiments. How can we ship those configurations together? so to bundle everything what is really important. Yeah, and then there are about, I don't know, 100 or more than 100 tests. Yeah, so if you open the tiddlers, which have a prefix test, then you can see the different tests that I'm using to test the plugin, if everything works. And in normal cases, they are relatively short and only test one element of the plugin. Yeah? So if you understand what's inside, then you also get a better understanding of the whole plugin and the mechanism and how everything is configured. Because in normal cases, every configuration is part of the tiddler itself, except for those which go for import custom and the global definitions. Yeah? So yeah, there are 100 examples. If you play with them, then you get a good overview what is possible, and if you understand them, then you can use the plugin. Yeah, that's basically it for the table of contents. Have fun, and the next videos will be about the reference. See you soon.